Wallaga Dan, Yuin Language, Yuinda. My name is Warren Foster. I'm Yuin, Yuin Language, me. Come from Wallaga Lake, eh?
First sort of language we learned was when we come down the lake, eh, and we swimming when we, as kids, and first language we learned was Bimbala.
Back up home there on a bit of land, I was only little at. And the older siblings and cousins and that, they usually go out there and they dive for the Bimbalas and they throw them in the shore. And when we were little, we just pick them up and bring them in, put them on the fire and that.
As we come up then, we picked up other words and that, and hearing older people speaking and that. A lot of language was sort of lost back because we weren't really allowed to speak it. A lot of it sort of laid down, like a lot of language, and rested. And then there's been a big resurgence of that language coming back. When we did get them CDs of it, old people talking, we was listening to it and confirming, oh yeah, that's the word, it does mean that, that's what it is. And some other words that we didn't know, I'm like, oh, that's that word. It's like a big snake or a big gurry, and you're just laying there asleep, waiting for the right people to come and wake it up. When I was growing up, a lot of the old people, they used to tell us that the language was still in the land. So we just have to go out and wake it up. Language is connected to everything that we do. See the water, when we call it mudjang, and then we'd change it a little bit to ngajang, and that means mother. Because mother holds water too, when she gives birth. So she's a holder of water, and ngajung, that's him, ngajung. Like up and down the coast and that, we had similar words and that. Like even shared words with the Wiradjuri mob and Nerigo, like Yuringanj and Nerigo were similar because of that connection we had with the Monero and the Nerigo people up in the mountain country. Because we spoke language on country, in different countries and different languages and all around Australia and that, well, the land, it was only used to them languages, yeah? When we spoke to the trees or to the water, even the wind and that, then they respond. Say the name of a tree, you see that tree move and it's responding. So we know that, yeah, that they listen. That's why when we go into sacred places and that, we got to let them old people know that, yeah, we're coming in with respect.
Namban, Goyang, Jiralingam, Baby Jalaga, Binjada. Guru, Ganin Mulaga, Walagadan, Yuinda. Munyup, Yamaga, Buraja.
We feel that connectedness to that country, to that land, knowing that the land's listening.
Language connects everything from law, song, dance, fire, ceremonies. That's really important for us to keep and maintain and bring back language too, because language is always evolving.
Language gives us our identity and identification of who we are.
and where we're coming from. So when we speak about our language, it speaks about the country. See? Like our language is Yuringan, and we live in Yuringan country, or we here sitting on Yuringan country. And it gives our kids that sense of pride of who they are, where they come from, and yeah, it helps them through school and life in general. They've got a good idea of who they are and where they come from and who their people are and what language they speak. I read a lot of language that I was taught down just for my kids, and that there's something for them to have. And there's a lot of Durga words in it, or Durga words, and a lot of Yuin words. We feel privileged and honoured to hold what them old fellows taught us. And so now it's my turn to be the teacher and pass it on. We are one of the oldest continuous living cultures going because of that. When I take my journey, I know that that's going to be continuing, and it gives us a lot of pride and being proud of who we are as Indigenous people, and makes it even better too that we know that that's going to continue and continue and continue for hopefully forever. Yeah.